You know, music is a way to communicate that is different than any other form of communication.
It would be a bit much to say that music saved the Little Miami School District. Not financially, anyway. But spiritually, that's another story. Not spiritually in the religious sense, but spiritually in the sense of I am here, I have purpose.
Nothing was supposed to survive in Little Miami, and we did.
Alto's back down to dulled.
This is the Little Miami High School Select Women's Chorale.
So it's like, I just worked up all this courage to try out for this choir. Freshman year hit, and my friends told me, hey, you should do choir.
But I got into it my freshman year and I literally loved it so much.
Till the spirit moves in my heart, I'm gonna sing till Jesus comes.
But that first year in choir for girls who are now seniors, 2010, nearly became the last. Voters had rejected 8 straight tax levy increases. The 4,500 student system was hemorrhaging money, heading for insolvency. And in 2010, the state of Ohio declared a fiscal emergency, taking over the district. 2 school buildings were closed, busing reduced, more than 100 teachers let go, and the budget for activities like the Women's Chorale cut to 0.
We were scared. I started looking for other jobs.
The chorale, which music teacher Sarah Baker had built over a decade from nearly nothing to a top-rated competitive ensemble, was on the verge of extinction. A disaster not only for Baker, but for young people at a vulnerable age.
I finally found my niche in high school. This is where I feel comfortable. This is where I feel welcome and accepted. And it was kind of a shock figuring out that this might not even be here next year and then I wouldn't really have anything.
But as show business script as it may sound, Sarah Baker literally willed the Select Women's Chorale to survive.
Music comes from the soul, it comes from your heart and your mind and your body.
Baker filled the music room with inspiration, powerful for kids looking to believe. Baker stayed at Little Miami, not jumping ship for a more financially secure district. The girls did fundraising concert after concert. Parents contributed. As long as we have a choir, Baker told her students, we will give it everything we have. She did, they did.
You just need to decide how you are going to behave and how what kind of attitude you want to have.
And your eyes need to sparkle each time, yeah.
Well, during class, we'd push on. We'd have the crazy amount of performances outside of the school district. That like baffled me when I was in this choir. I was like, oh goodness. Now I have no free time on the weekends to do things with my friends, but luckily they're all in the choir, so it didn't really matter.
In November 2011, Little Miami voters finally said yes to a school tax increase, though the fiscal emergency was not lifted for nearly 2 more years. Many of the budget cuts, including the choir's funding for music and buses to concerts, were ultimately restored. But just when it seemed like things were finally smoothing out, there was another huge roadblock last fall.
The accident happened on a Friday evening. I fell off my horse preparing for a show over in Indian Hill.
Baker, an accomplished equestrian, shattered her kneecap. Remember, that was on a Friday. On Monday, she was back in school on crutches, only took 2 days off after surgery, and conducted rehearsals and concerts from a wheelchair.
My attitude is very much like, okay, when you have an obstacle, you figure out a different way. You figure out another way to make things work. And I needed to be here with these girls. I needed to do these things with them.
Like get them ready for international competition. This choir, which was pulled from the brink of extinction by a dynamic teacher and by students who refused to give up, is going to the World Choir Games in Riga, Latvia later this summer.
I'm just so excited.
Rightfully so. And while music did not really save the Little Miami School District, the power of voices together, sending out a message, I am here, I have purpose, may be the most important lesson these young people ever received.
I'm just so thankful and so proud of everybody. I'm thankful to have Mrs. Baker and to be able to be with her through this whole thing and to be able to be with these girls through the whole thing, because we've gone through a lot together and they're my family.
If we try, Lord, if we try.
I'm immensely proud of this group. Like, my love for them is wholehearted and so deep in my core.
I think we like the image of being like an underdog kind of like, and we just, our Cinderella story. I think it's pretty awesome to know that like we're one of the few things from Little Miami that like prevailed.
But I know that my life and my experience with these ladies has been one of the most rewarding experiences that I've had. And it's my life, and I know for a lot of them it is too. It's a way that we feel closer to what our purpose as human beings is supposed to be on this earth. To know that we can promote peace and love and happiness and joy and support for each other. We can do it here.
Little Miami, big example. Jeff Hirsch, Local 12 News.